What's the point of driving a hybrid if you're just gonna go above the speed limit and all that shit? I guess, I don't know, still. This seems a little off. Still 40. You know, you could pull forward like 12 feet, just saying. Some of the worst fucking intersections. Not to mention placement of fucking places to shop. It's fucking ridiculous. Oh, and my favorite, which is unfortunate in itself, but still slows down traffic even more. The Bakers. You stop, you open your window, you roll down your window, you reach over, you give them a dollar, you drop the dollar, the guy's in traffic, who knows, it's still. Then you got people over here just parking for no reason. Oh wait, that's because you can't get to the in and out easily. Yeah. How amazing is that? Fucking ridiculous is what it is. Come on! Speed up. Speed up. Speed up. Thank you. Efficient. I know I need a big ass fucking truck to slow down traffic. Freeway. That's how I roll. There's one to go with the flow of traffic. Something rickety. Thank you. Look at that. That was so safe. Cut between the junk monster and the fucking 18-wheeler with the fucking steel iron. Sharp as fuck if it's flying at your windshield. High bars. I mean, that's what I want to have on my way to school. And you have more dipshits not paying attention to flow traffic. Oh, and the polluting truck. Oh, thank God for the polluting truck. At least my fucking vents are off. Oh, no, I can still smell it. Thanks to my fucking super sense of smell. That smells like fucking roses, not. Oh, look. The highway sign. Watch out for workers, because there is no workers out because someone keeps hitting them with their fucking cars. They actually won't be out for a few days. Oh, wait, no, it's like a month. So the highways are going to turn to shit as people litter. Continue to drive like fucking maniacs, I guess. But that's their prerogative. Hand jobs and Porsches and such. Because, you know, everyone can drive perfectly fine as they're getting a blowjob in their Porsche. Oh, the junk monster. Hello, junk monster. Fucking hate driving. Holy shit, pods. Slow the fuck down. It wouldn't be so bad if people actually had an ability to communicate. You know, hey, I'm trying to get over here, or I'd like to go that way, or excuse me, can I pass you real quick? But instead, all you can do is flip a blinker, hope someone sees it, and doesn't fucking run into you. Or you can be the junk monster and try to make a U-turn or something at this light up here, which is going to work out really well for him because he just decided to go over two lanes. Oh, man. I mean, this red light's very efficient. I'll get off the freeway, stop at a light, stop at another light. Go another half a mile, quarter mile up the hill, stop at another light, try to get over a lane, cut people off. Shit just doesn't work well. Especially when you decide to change lanes in the middle of an intersection, but unfortunately, that's the only place you can do it sometimes. And then you got people who just, all want to go to the mall, and they don't realize that in order to go to the mall, you gotta be on one side of the street. And then the ones that do, block traffic. Fortunately for me today, no concern. Seems clear. Oh, never mind. I got a bus. And so much for 35. It's 20. Oh, another people want to go to the mall. I don't know how to get to the mall. 35, still going 25. Oh, there's a Mustang behind me. And all the people want to go to the hospital and they get stuck at a red light because it just recycles. And I finally get to go 35. Top of the hill. Oh, but look, I just met my red light. Now I get to wait another 10 minutes. Way too many dips, way too many speed bumps. So ridiculous. No one's going downhill. I've got to be the worst if you hit them fast. Even a little bit faster, they really jar the fuck out of you. But that's why they call them a speed bump, I suppose, to fuck up your car. Put you in some pain. Fortunately, for me, I get physical pain. And yeah, the lack of sidewalks is amazing, but who cares? I got all this great shrubbery and shit that needs to be cut every 2 weeks. Gas-powered fucking trimmers and hedgers and blowers and other craziness, which doesn't really do much except for, you know, make the place look nice to look at, but, you know, if they had kept natural plants, it would possibly still be nice to look at, but, I don't know, this place was built in the 60s or whatever.